There are two main types of tests you can add to your Android project: unit tests and connected tests. The primary distinction between the two is that unit tests run on a regular Java VM on your computer, and connected tests run on an Android device or emulator. In general, you should use unit tests for testing generic non-Android related classes. In fact, since unit tests are run against a mock Android SDK implementation, any code that calls the Android API will fail. In this case, you should either use a mocking framework like Mockito to mock the appropriate Android dependencies, or use a connected test instead. Additionally, you can configure the testing options in your Gradle build script to instruct the mock Android implementation to return default values rather than throw an error. In any case, it's up to you as a developer to decide how to best write your tests and how to structure your code in such a way as to make testing easier. Connected tests should be reserved for testing logic that depends on Android APIs, or for more high-level testing like integration and functional tests. Remember, connected tests are packaged as an APK that will be installed on an Android device or emulator, so there's typically more overhead involved in their execution. Both unit tests and connected tests have their own source sets, named test and Android test, respectively. The notion of variance extends to tests as well, allowing you to write tests specific to a particular build type or product flavor. The naming conventions for these source sets follow the same pattern as for application code, except for the test or Android test suffix.